Hi, this is Penny, and in this lesson, I'm going to review how we see objects, like this chameleon, in color. We already know that visible light includes all the colors of the rainbow. Red, orange, yellow, green, blue, indigo, and violet. And these colors represent different wavelengths or frequencies of light. If we shine a white light on an object, the color we see depends on how the light interacts with that object, and which wavelengths are reflected and which are refracted and absorbed. And now, let's look at how our eyes and brain work together to allow us to perceive color. Believe it or not, we aren't born with the full ability to see in color. Your eyes have the equipment, but your brain just isn't ready. It actually takes about 6 to 8 months for us to fully develop the ability to detect different colors. So once our brains are ready, how do we detect the color of an object? When light strikes an object, such as this yellow toy, we know from our previous lesson that the yellow wavelength of light is reflected and the rest of the visible spectrum is absorbed. Some of that reflected light will reach our eyes, which are built to receive messages in the form of light. Light first enters the eye through the cornea. It then continues through the pupil, which is the small opening in the center of the colored part of your eye. The light continues on through the lens and eventually strikes a light-sensitive, paper-thin layer that covers the inside of the eye called the retina. Now, this is where the magic happens. The retina contains millions of special cells divided into two types, rods and cones. The rods are far more numerous and sensitive to shades of gray. They are really sensitive and detect light even at low levels. But these cells don't tell us anything about color, so we'll forget about these for now. Color detection takes place in the cones. There are three types of cones, and in a very general sense, each corresponds to different wavelengths of light. The red cones detect longer wavelengths, the green detect medium wavelengths, and the blue cones detect shorter wavelengths. These cones transmit messages to the brain via the optic nerve, which extends off the back of the eye. But how do these cones work with the brain to help us interpret color? Before we answer this question, have a look at this image showing the additive primary colors of light, red, green, and blue, which you may notice are the colors of our cones. We say additive because when we add all the primary colors together, we get the color white, as seen where all the colors overlap in the center. When we overlap two colors at a time, we get the secondary colors of yellow, magenta, and cyan. If we start mixing red, green, and blue in different amounts, we can produce many, many different colors. Sounds simple? All right. So getting back to our yellow toy. The yellow wavelength of light is between red and green on the visible spectrum. So when it strikes the cones in the retina, both the red and green cones are stimulated. A message is then sent to the brain through the optic nerve. If everything works normally, our brain interprets the information and we know we are seeing the color yellow. When light is reflected off this ribbon, the wavelength of light stimulates both the blue and green receptors, and the message sent to the brain interprets this as the color blue. The many different colors we see are the result of different cones being stimulated in different amounts. A healthy human eye can actually detect about 10 million different colors. But what if your cones don't function normally? About 1 in 8 men and 1 in 200 women suffer from some color deficiency or color blindness. These individuals can see clearly, but their perception of color is off. The most common type of color blindness is red-green. Here is what a vegetable stem will look like to a person with normal vision. Notice the vibrant green, orange, red, and yellow colors. Now here is what this image would look like with red-green color blindness. The red and green hues are washed out, and the vegetables all take on this golden brown color. Here's a quick check to see if you are color deficient or color blind. Each circle has a different number inside. Your job is to identify the number. When you're ready, pause the video, then hit play when you're ready to see the answers. Ready to see the answers? Okay. Let's do the top row first. The numbers are 7, 13, and 16. The numbers in the bottom row are 8, 12, and 9. Did you get them all right? If not, you may want to go get your eyes checked for color blindness. Remember, it's not that uncommon. And here is the big picture for this lesson. Some of the visible light emitted or reflected off an object will reach our eyes. Light travels through the eye to a layer at the back called the retina. The retina contains special cells called rods and cones, and cones are responsible for sending messages about color to the brain via the optic nerve. The brain interprets the messages and translates it into a color. Normal vision requires the three types of cones to be functioning normally. If one or more types of cones are damaged, the individual is said to be color deficient or color blind. Thanks for watching.